network all the time. So basically a solution could be knowing who is on your network, what are they doing, where are they going, can you control their activities, what kind of traffic is being sent out by them, and then knowing what they are doing, what can you do to prevent any bad activities. I will not go through this slide, it's too detailed, but I'll go to the next one, which is basically what you need for security in the network is you do need NAC, but you need everything based. Once you know, done the authentication in the NAC, you need identity based enforcement, which is threat prevention, network traffic, basically enforcing the policies related to each person on the network, preventing any threats which occur, have visibility into what actually is going on in the network, and also provide application level controls to policies. Typically you may have P2P or IM applications which you may not want to allow, or if you do allow, you want to make sure that they do not choke the network. So this kind of infrastructure is required to make sure that your network is secure. This is just one more region where you have identity based policies which are deployed, and each group, user group, can only see those resources which they are supposed to see. From a different perspective, you do need, it is often the policy of security experts to not just rely on one security mechanism but multi-layered security. That is because every security mechanism is vulnerable, can be bypassed, can be evaded. So you do need ways in which you have layers of security. So even if one layer has been bypassed, another one of the layers will catch it. So, and in that sense, you have perimeter security, you have endpoint security, you also need security in the LAN. This just indicates that the perimeter is not just the internet gateway, the LAN, all the endpoints on the LAN. And finally, after all this, what you do need is full visibility into what is going on in the network, a full security status across your entire corporate network. You need to be able to see at one point what's the status of the endpoints, are the OS patches installed, the antivirus is updated, etc. And what actually is going on in the network, are there any threats, any malicious traffic on the network, are the servers being used effectively, or some strange other different traffic pattern is visible, etc. So you do need to have this view of the whole network to be able to see what's going on in your network, and your network is safe. So that's all I have to say. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ajit, for explaining the various security options that come under the umbrella of NAC, the pros and cons of each, and also for reiterating Govind's point that the complexity of the networks demands multi-layered security. So NAC, as we would all have guessed, would not be the silver bullet to protect and provide endpoint security, and it might also not address business or application specific policy requirements. What we shall do now is that we'll move to question and answer session. If you have any questions, this please go ahead and shoot out the questions. Can we get a mic to
what are the best practices that we should follow to secure the endpoints? Because we just rushed through this slide.
Yeah, I know. In 15 minutes, explaining the concept of endpoint security on networks is extremely difficult. So if I summarize, one of the most important things that we recommend to customers, not only in India but across the world, is basically having the right kind of policies inside the organization, because policies is what basically defines and controls what enters your network and goes out of the network. It could be policies on the perimeter, it could be policies on your workstations, it could be policies on your gateways, but policies is an absolute absolute must. It's a you just cannot survive in today's world without the right kind of policies. For example, even in our organization, any kind of devices that enter the network will have to be authenticated. Without a proper kind of authentication, no entry is allowed. Same thing happens for maybe laptops, maybe it could be mobile phones or anything. So it's going to be the policies all the way for you to secure your networks.
Good, thank you.
If an organization wants to secure its endpoints, does it need to make any additional investment in hardware and software, or can it use the existing infrastructure, notably the features of the operating system and the applications? Existing infrastructure, the existing OS and applications and existing hardware, or do I need to make, what is the additional cost that goes towards securing the endpoints?
See, it's going to, I cannot put the exact cost, but just for a simple example, if I bring in my laptop inside your network, I put it on your land and I try to use your resources, are you going to allow me? That's the biggest question that I will ask you. If you say you are going to allow me without any kind of a control, for example, what we spoke about, a NAC or a NAC, which basically ensures that endpoints are properly secured before they are given access to the network. Now, it's a concept which has come about maybe in the last 4 years, 5 years, and most of the organizations have just not worked on it. So you need to invest in having these kind of policies or having these kind of authentications enforced inside an organization. And if you don't enforce these kind of policies using some kind of a hardware or some kind of a software, it's virtually impossible for organizations to protect themselves.
You has told us about the threats, and that is known to all of us, I believe so, whoever is in this IT field. But I don't think that you have given us any solution. Like if I start with you, MicroWorld, that you said that USB device, if I bring some data through USB device and I copy some files and then I give it to someone else, that is very common. If I tell my president or my, I am from media, so if I tell my editor, don't bring any story to USB drive and don't copy it in the laptop, then he will tell me, then what kind of system you are maintaining. So what I believe, what I thought, that I would get some more information on the solution. Threats are known to everybody. So if I am using my laptop in my LAN, it can be a protected LAN. Maybe the servers are protected with passwords and all. The moment I bring my laptop in the LAN and I put USB device, how can I protect that USB data will not be copied into the file server, or the moment I connect USB drive or I connect internet, my LAN will be disconnected? So all this information I think will be useful to us.
Okay, as a session chair I will jump in. What has happened is that they've, here we're not allowed to push products. So they've touched upon the solutions, but I think what would be appreciated is if all of you can also provide us with the landscape of the technical solutions available. For example, NAC is one, DLP is another one. If you can just provide us, you know, an overview of the broad technology solutions available to address the problems that you've brought up. Thank you very much for that question. We'll start with Ajit, maybe, if you would like to.
Okay. Can you hear me? Place in which even when you put in a bad USB, infected USB device into a PC, the PC can catch infections over there and we will block it. There are often cases where the antivirus, etc., all the tools on the PCs are not updated or not up to speed. Then it can push bad traffic onto the network, and that's where what I talked about, security in the LAN. So you can detect all kinds of bad activity on the LAN and then prevent the PC from getting onto the network. So those are ways in which you can actually block things.